Okay, so now that we have worked around the third row, which is the yellow part, you've come around it. Now we're going to the last bit of it, the last cluster. So insert your left sting to this orange bead at the bottom, and also for that yellow bead pointing upwards. Then salik up with the yellow bead. Then we're going to work on the fourth row, which is the green one. You can use light green or dark green, but I think dark green is best for this. So insert our string, two green on the right, and then salik up with a green. You just work on it like this and up to the violet part and you will be okay. So now you see that there is that green part there. So just going to insert your left string to this yellow bead. Then you can work on it on your own. Put a green on the right, and then salik up with the green one. Then you work around it using the green bead, and I'm gonna catch up with you right before I end it. Hi guys, so we're now closing the fourth row, the green part. Now we have it here. You may realize, or you may see, that the end part or the end cluster goes in different places, but that's okay. It's supposed to be like that. Insert your left string to this yellow bead, and also for the green one, and you're going to complete that last row 4 with the green, salik up with the green one to close the fourth row. Then we're going to start with the fifth color, and that is blue. And since I don't have the appropriate type of shade of blue, I'm using this type, some type of sky blue, but it's okay, it works, as you can see. Put two blue ones on the right and salik up with a blue one. So this is the fifth row. Now you're just going to assemble it just like the other ones. Insert your left string to this green adjacent bead. Put one blue on the right and salik up with the blue one. And you can work on it on your own up until we close it, and I'm going to show you the last row, which is the violet part. And after that, I'm going to show how to put this strap or the strippers. I'm hoping that it is visible. You can see it better here. I have other design for it, like this ones, and I'm going to make a separate video for this. And it's best to have a diagram, as I have been working on it, so you can have a reference like this one. But you can also just follow the tutorial I'm making. Okay, so I'm gonna catch up with you after you have done that part. Okay, so now we're in the last cluster for the fifth row. Insert your left string to this green bead, and also for the blue going upwards. Then we're going to salik up with the blue one. Then we're going to work in the last row, which is the violet part. Okay. To start it, we need to put two violet ones, and then salik up with the violet. Two on the right and salik up with the violet one. And you're just going to work on it around, just like the other rows. And I'm going to show you that next. The string will be enough for the strap part, so don't worry. Okay guys, so now we're in the last bits of the tutorial. Now that we are here, we're just going to close the gap, or we're going to complete that classroom 4. Sa liko pwede violet bead. And after this, we're just going to close the gap at the top part of it, putting 2 beads in between. So what I always do is I look for the longer string, because you will end up with an uneven string. So what I do is I go for the longest string, I put 1 bead or 1 violet bead. So since we're here, we're just going to insert it to the other side to complete the cluster 4. And then I put another violet bead on that right string. We're going to the other side. So what we need to do next is we're just going to tighten this so that it will be rigid, so it wouldn't be that loose. So we need to insert the string to several beads around. Going to catch up with you after that. Okay, so now that we have passed the both strings into several beads, it will not be movable or wouldn't move that much. We're going to a part of the slippers to form the strap. Okay, so we need to go to the middle part of this blue. Switch your right string to this bead, go into the left, and the other one, you need to go the other way around, so insert it here, and then you need to pinch it so it will we'll go through it. Then the next thing to do is, so I'm going to use another color of beads so you will know, or you will see. Put one on the right and one on the left. And then we're going to silico with that gray beads. Okay? So now we have that in the middle part. So we're going to work on the right string first. You will need to put 4 gray beads on the string and you pass it through this yellow bead here, okay? So that it will end up like that, okay? That is the first strap. Then work on the other shorter string. Put 4 gray beads there. You also pass it through that yellow bead. Okay? So you'll make the other side of the strap. So now you have this. So what we need to do now is we need to fasten it so that it will close. So what I usually do is I go for the longer string. I pass it through several beads so that it will go to that other string so we can knot it. I'm knotting it in order for the strap not to move, so that the strap won't move, okay? We're on the other string. I just knotted once so that it wouldn't be that visible. Then yes, we're just going to fasten it. Get one of the strings and pass it through several beads to fasten it. And then we're just going to cut the excess. Okay? So, now you have that rainbow-colored chinelas keychain or slippers. And what is left for us to do for this is the keychain part, the keyring part. You just need to insert it to the middle part. Okay? So, that is the end of the tutorial. I hope that you love learning them as much as I enjoy teaching them to you. That's it for now. Goodbye.